today's affirmation is I'm hot and I'm bi. Making me mentally stable would have been unfair.
Heart beats fast, colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? Watching you stand alone, all of my doubt suddenly goes away somehow. One step closer. I have died every day waiting for you. Darling, don't be afraid. I have loved you for a thousand years. I love you for a thousand more.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Midnight Minute, where I take a whole minute to talk about myself and some of my hobbies. Today is a hobby that I've had ever since I was in high school. It's a collection. And if you can't see it, I collect fans. I really like fans. This one says Roll for Initiative. This one's from the Haunted Mansion. Pride, Disney. I got this one from an arcade. I just thought this one was pretty. Another pretty one. I have been incorporating some of these in cosplays. And sometimes when I go to little shops, I'll pick them up. Like this one. Some of these I got from a Lunar New Year festival. Some of these are really, really old, like I've gotten them years ago. This was actually one of the very first fans I ever got. This is one of my favorites. It's so pretty and it looks hand-painted. It's so cute. And honestly, I'm still collecting them, but I'm looking for more unique ones now. Like this one's really pretty and unique. These two are really pretty and unique. I believe this one was gifted to me. This is the second fan I've ever gotten from a Lunar festival. And I made this one because I wanted a bi flag, but I'm in the market for a new one, so.
Could you be a voice actor?
I always wanted
to. Do it this video to find out. One script, 15 seconds. This is the Disney Intro Voiceover Challenge. Starting now.
We have our heading.
Here we go!
From the magic within our hearts to the adventure beyond the horizon, there is only one.
Everybody wanna look like us, and everybody wanna talk like us. Everybody wanna dress like us. Don't nobody wanna stress like us. Everybody wanna look.
In case nobody told you today, you're special. In case nobody made you believe.
Questions for women. Blind react to this. Hi. I really just wanted to tell you that you are beautiful and valid and brilliant and kind and cool and funny and wonderful, and you deserve nothing but joy in life. And so I hope, if nothing else, this video will make you truly smile today. Also, I guess I'm supposed to ask you at least something, so, how do you like my hair? It's pretty cool, isn't it? Anyway, have a wonderful day.
I'm curious, what role y'all play at the family gatherings? I'm the cousin that loves to debate.
I've always been the cousin that is drawing in the corner and doesn't want to be talked to, because honestly, I don't know any of you guys, and I don't really want to be here right now, but I was forced to be here. So please don't talk to me, let me draw in my corner.
When people call you extra, just look them in their face and say, am I extra or are you basic? Be a blessing.
Hello, and welcome to Black Woman Bare Minimum, a safe space where you can do the least and be the most. Here's my effort for today.
What is something a man did for you that made you realize that you've been accepting?
So boys in high school used to make me feel like my standards were way too high, but then they didn't want me because I was fat. So it was a really weird thing where they were like, well, since you're a fat girl, you should get what you can get. And I'd be like, no. And then I met my currently now husband, who, by the way, had a crush on me in high school and didn't tell me until we were well past high school. On our third date, I believe. The third date! This man took me to Disney World. This man said, hey, I'm planning a like week trip to go to Universal Studios in Florida and Disney World, and would you like to come with me? You know, you're my girlfriend. I'd love to spend that time with you. I hadn't even had a boyfriend who really wanted to even show me to his friends because they thought I was fat and their friends would make fun of them for it. This man took me to Disney World. Disney World on our third date. So yeah, we're married, yeah. Just like the day that I met you, the day I thought forever, said that you love me, but that'll last forever. It's cold outside, like when you walked out my life, why you walked out my life.
Don't make fun of me. I'm trying my best.
Hi, in light of Black History Month, you are obligated to tell every Black person that you see on your For You page that they are beautiful, starting with me. Thank you. Oh my god.
Hey everybody, and I'm Midnight Persona, and welcome back to Midnight Minute, which I have not done for a while because I haven't really been feeling myself to talk about myself, so we're gonna do a quick Midnight Minute. I just wanted to do a really cute kind of makeup today because I was recording a few little side videos, so yeah. I don't know if I've really talked about it on TikTok, but I always used to, a long time ago, want to be a singer. My very first job as a child that I wanted to do was marine biology, and then I found out about sharks. Now I know the sharks aren't as harmful as people make them out to be, and I've passed that window. But growing up, I always really, really wanted to be a singer. I love singing. It's like a pastime kind of hobby thing for me. I have horrible stage fright, though. Like, I love singing so much, and my hubby really loves my singing, and I have friends who love my singing, and we go to karaoke and have a blast. But I have terrifying stage fright. Anybody who saw the videos, I did a karaoke contest and I actually made it in the finals, but my voice was so bad because I was so terrified. But yeah, I really love singing. I have so many stories. I'm gonna talk about one in particular because I had a load of friends who always would gaslight me and being like, you're being too dramatic about this, even though someone said something really offensive to me. You could guess that they were all white girls. But one in particular that happened recently, like a few years back. I was doing my thing on Twitter talking about how the injustices of being Black in the community and how, you know, I just feel like things are unfair. And I was basically ranting and feeling really bad. And this person, and I won't give any names or anything, came into my comments and were like, I know exactly how you feel. I went through it too. Mind you, this person is white. They basically were like, I grew up in a majority Black and Hispanic high school, and I was teased and people threw things at me and I was made fun of and yada yada yada. And I was like, okay, I understand that. That sucks. I'm sorry you went through that growing up, but I'm talking about a systemic problem, like racism all over the world kind of situation where I will always seem lesser than. And they were like, I know, I'm agreeing with you. I get it. I felt it before. And I was trying so hard not to be mean. I was trying so hard. And I was like, no, you don't get it. You will never get it. I'm sorry, you are white. And I understand that you were bullied when you were growing up. I was bullied too, because I was a fat girl and Black. But they went on and on and on and insisted that they knew exactly how I felt and that I was being mean to them by belittling their issues. And I was just kind of like, I'm talking about being Black in a racist America, and you're comparing it to being bullied in high school. And they just would not listen, no matter what I did. They were always like, oh, you don't understand. They almost went into saying that they were bullied for being fat, and I was like, I am fat, I know. I get bullied every day still. And this went on for almost a week because they decided after I went, girl, I'm done. I can't deal with this right now. And I basically cut them off. I wasn't going to talk to them. And they decided to tell all their friends how I was bullying them and how I was mean and how I was going off and not trusting them and yada, yada, yada. They made several stories about me on Instagram without saying my name and being like, I thought you were my friend. I thought you understood. I'm bipolar and I have all these other issues wrong with me and you just didn't understand and you belittled me. None of this happened. I was just like, girl, you don't get it. It's I'm talking about a bigger issue than being bullied. I was bullied too, so I get it, but I'm talking about a bigger issue here. And they did not want to hear it. And so I also took what they said and I posted and said, tell me if I'm wrong here, but like comparing racism to being bullied in high school, that's not correlated, right? Mind you, I know it wasn't correlated, but I just was like, someone back me up, please. And I did have a friend back me up and be like, just step down. It ain't cool. Stop it. But it was crazy. Oh my God.